Today I am going to teach you saddle point from the game theory chapter. So in this video we will discuss about saddle point with the help of examples. At last we will define saddle point also. So welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share and subscribe. Problem number 1. Find the value of gain, and this payoff matrix is given to you. And here you can see there are the two players, player A and player B. Player A having 3 strategies, 1, 2, 3, whereas player B having 4 strategies, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is payoff matrix. So simply we can say this is the gains for the player A. So try to understand the meaning of this. Say for example this 4, so it indicates that if the player A follows second strategy and player B follows third strategy, then the value of game is 4, and that is gain by the player A, and the same, that is loss by the player B. Now here the question is about the value of gain. So once again look at the steps that also we have discussed in earlier video. First, write the payoff matrix. So here this payoff matrix is directly given to you. Now next, apply maximin minimax principle. So now I am going to apply the maximin minimax principle. First, find out the row minima. That means the minimum value from each row. So here look at the values from the row 1 and select the minimum value. So here it is -5. Then pick up the minimum value from the row 2. So here it is 4. Next, pick up the minimum value from the row 3. So here it is -6. So here we have selected the minimum value from each row. Now maximin, that means now pick up the maximum value from each minimum values. So this is the maximum value. So I can say maximin means maximum out of row minimum. So here you can understand maximin. So once again we have selected the maximum value out of row minimum. So that is called as maximin principle. Now we are going to apply the minimax principle. So first find out the column maxima. That means maximum value from each column. So here select the maximum value from the column number 1. So here it is 5. Next, maximum value from column number 2. So here it is 5. Next, maximum value from column number 3. So here it is 4. Next, maximum value from column number 4. So here it is 20. Now select the minimum value from column maxima row. So here this one is the minimum. So this is called as minimax principle. Minimum value out of maximum. So we can say minimum out of column maxima. Mini and max. So it is called as minimax principle. Now look at this both value. If these both values are same, then the intersection point is known as saddle point. So this is the saddle point. So here saddle point is P2, 3. Once again look at the step. Is there a saddle point? So yes, in this problem we have the saddle point, and that is P2, 3. So here we can say yes. So identify value of game and optimal strategy directly. So now I can write directly the value of gain, that is equal to 4, and that is exactly the value at the saddle point. And so that I can write directly optimal strategy also for both the players. So for player A, I can say second strategy is the optimal strategy, and for player B, third strategy is the optimal strategy. So this is the solution of the game. So solution of game, that means there are two answers. One is a value of gain and another one is the optimal strategies. So here this 2 and 3 is not actually the amount, but it is the second strategy for player A and third strategy for player B. Next, if V is equal to 0, that means value of game is equal to 0 at saddle point, means a game is fair game. So this is actually the special comment on this problem. So if it is asked, then you can give your special comment. But here value of game is not 0, so it is not a fair game. Now second problem, solve the following game and this payoff is given to you. So here the title is what? Solve the following game. That means there are two different objectives. One is the value of game and another one is the optimal strategy for player A and for player B. So once again look at the step. First write down the payoff matrix that is given to you here. Now next, apply maximin and minimax principle. So maximin for player A. So first I have to find the minimum value and then I can select the maximum. So it is called as maximin principle. So I am going to write first the minimum value, that is called as row minima. So select the minimum value from the row 1. So that is 1. Next, minimum value from row 2, that is 5. Next, minimum value from row 3, that is 3. Next, minimum value from row 4, so here it is 2. Now, select the maximum value from this row minima, so here it is 5. Maximum value out of all minimum value. Now, I am going to apply the minimax principle. That means first I am going to select the maximum value from each column and then select the minimum value, that is called as minimax principle. So I can write over here column maxima. So select the maximum value from column 1. So here it is 10. Similarly maximum value from column 2. So 7. Maximum value from column 3. So here 5. Maximum value from column 4. So here it is 9. Maximum value from column number 5. So once again here it is 9. Now select the minimum value and that's why it is called as minimax principle. So minimum value is 5. So once again look at this value. Both values are same and so that I can say the intersection of these two is called as saddle point. So this is called as saddle point. Now once again look at this tab. Is there a saddle point? So here definitely this one is the saddle point. So I can identify value of game as well as optimal strategy directly. So here as maximin and minimax values, that means these two values are same at point A to B3. So strategy is called as optimal strategy or you can say pure strategy. So game is called stable game. So if there is a saddle point, then we can say the game is stable game. And this common point A to B3 is called as saddle point. And the value at saddle point is called as value of game. So I can write over here value of game is equal to 5. And the optimal strategy for player A is A2. And for player B is B3. So now it is very easy to define the saddle point. So let's see the definition of saddle point. It is an element of a matrix that is both the lowest element in its row and the highest element in its column. So look at once again very important point. Lowest element in its row, simultaneously it is the highest element in its column. So look at the problem number 1 that already we have discussed. Here 4 is the saddle point. So here you can see lowest element in its row. So here you can see the row number 2 in which it is lowest. Now look at the corresponding column. This one is the highest. So we can say lowest element in its row and highest element in its column. If you want to see more videos of operation research, like a simplex method, big M method, transportation problem, assignment, then subscribe my YouTube channel and go to the playlist. So thanks my dear friends, press the like button to appreciate this video.